What's going on, guys? In this video we are going to see six basic quadratic surfaces, and also we are going to define the quadratic surfaces. Also we are going to see the graphs of these quadratic surfaces. Now let's look at this part right here. So it says a quadratic surface is given by a degree 2 equation in the form of ax squared plus by squared plus zz squared, and like this, right? And let's look at the types. Here we have ellipsoid, hyperboloid of one sheet, hyperboloid of two sheets, elliptic cone, elliptic paraboloid, hyperbolic paraboloid. And the degree and the sign of the degree 2 terms, as well as which terms are present, help determine which of the 6 basic quadratic surfaces given. To graph a quadratic surface, it often helpful to graph the xy trace, xz trace, and yz trace. These are the intersection of the surface with these three planes. To determine xy trace, set z is equal to 0. To determine xz trace, set y is equal to 0. To determine yz trace, set x is equal to 0. Now let's look at the first type. So this is ellipsoid right here. And the characteristics, all three degree 2 terms are present, right? So here we have x square, y square, z square. And all three degree 2 terms are positive when equation equal to 1, right? So these three are positive. And all three traces are ellipses. And this is our graph right here. Now let's look at another graph. Okay. And ellipsoid. And if you look at this one, this looks like circle, but this should be ellipse shape right here, right? And if you look at this z plane, here we have xz plane. That is a ellipse shape, right? And if you look at this xy plane, that's also an ellipse. And let's look at yz plane. Yz plane, that's also an ellipse, right? So three traces are going to be ellipse shape. Now let's look at next one. Next one, we have hyperboloid of one sheet. The characteristics is going to be all three two terms are present. All three degree 2 terms are present, x square, y square, z square, and 2 degree 2 terms are positive, and 1 degree 1 is negative when equation is equal to 1. And here we have negative z square, but it doesn't have to be always z. It can be anything, like x can be, or y, anything can be negative, right? But it has to be just 1. And then one trace is an ellipse, two traces are hyperbolas, axis is parallel to negative variable. And this is our graph right here. And here it says two traces are hyperbolas, right? One trace is an ellipse. Now let's look at this graph. Hyperboloid one sheet, right? Hyperboloid one sheet. And if you look at this one, this this is xy trace. Xy trace is an ellipse. This look like a circle, but it's an ellipse actually, right? And if you look at this one, this is yz trace, and that is a hyperbola. You can see this is opening like this and also opening like this. So this is a hyperbola. And let's look at xz trace. Xz trace, this is also a hyperbola, right? And that is the hyperboloid of one sheet. Now let's look at next one. Hyperboloid of two sheet. The characteristics is going to be all three degree 2 terms are present, x square, y square, z square, and 2 degree 2 terms are negative, and 1 is positive when equation equal to 1. So here we have negative, negative, positive. It can be anything, like this can be negative z, negative x, or it can switch around, right? And then two traces are hyperbolas. One trace will be ellipse parallel to the third plane. Axis is parallel to positive variable. So two traces are hyperbolas. One trace will be an ellipse. Okay, hyperboloid of two sheet. This one XY is an ellipse, right? You can see this look like a circle, but it's an ellipse. And if you see the XZ plane, this is a hyperbola. And if you look at YZ plane, that's also a hyperbola, right? So this is hyperboloid of two sheets. Now let's look at the next one. Elliptical cone. The characteristics, all 3 degree, two terms are present. X square, y square, z square. And then 2 degree, two terms are positive and one negative when equation is equal to zero. So previously we had equation is equal to one, right? Here it is zero, and this is like similar to hyperboloid one sheet. Here we have one and this is zero, right? And this is the elliptical cone, and the two traces are hyperbolas. One trace will be a point or ellipse parallel to the third plane. Two traces are hyperbolas. One trace will be a point or ellipse parallel to the third plane, right? Axis is parallel to the negative variable. Now let's look at this one. Elliptical cone. Okay, let's get rid of this. Okay, XY, it's an ellipse shape, right? And let's look at this one. We have Z, Y plane. That is, okay, here they say hyperbolas, and here you can see it's a hyperbola right here, right? And this is YZ plane. Let's look at XZ plane. That's also a hyperbola. Okay, so that's how elliptic cones look like. Now let's look at the next one. Next one we have elliptic paraboloid. Let's look at the characteristics. The first one is 2 degree, two terms present. X square, y square, 2 degree, two terms. 1 degree, one term. Z is one term. And one trace is an ellipse. Two traces are parabolas. Axis is parallel to 2 degree, one variable. So 1 degree, one trace is an ellipse. Two traces are parabolas. Elliptic paraboloid. Okay. So XY trace is an ellipse, right? And ZY plane is a parabola. And also you can see XZ plane also a parabola. So this is our elliptic paraboloid. Now let's look at next one. Hyperbolic paraboloid. Characteristics, 2 degree, two terms are present. One is positive and one is negative. So X square, Y square. And let's compare with the previous one. We have X square, Y square, but here plus. Here we have minus, right? Plus, minus. And negative. 1 degree, one term. Z is one term, and one trace is hyperbola, two traces are parabolas, axis is parallel to 2 degree, one variable. Now let's go ahead and see this one, hyperbolic paraboloid. Hyperbolic paraboloid, here we go. Okay, let's look at XY trace. XY trace. So XY trace should be a hyperbola. So we should get a shape like little bit curve, a little bit like parabola kind of stuff, but this is not better illustrating. But this one XY should be a hyperbola. Now let's look at other plane, and we can see that XZ plane, you can see parabolas, right? Parabola. And YZ plane, also parabola. Okay, and that's our hyperbolic paraboloid shape. And that's it. I hope this helps. Thanks for watching.